Welcome back. Imagine we have a machine that generates a discrete random number x from 1 to 10. It has generated these 7 numbers 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, 4 and 1. Let's calculate the mean of these numbers. To get the mean, sum these numbers and divide by 7. Rearranging the numbers, we get 1 into 3 by 7 plus 2 into 1 by 7 plus 3 into 1 by 7 plus 4 into 2 by 7. These fractions 3 by 7, 1 by 7 and 2 by 7 are the frequencies of 1, 2, 3 and 4 in the data. So we can say to get the mean, multiply a number with its frequency and then sum over all the numbers. Now let's generalize this definition of mean and move from frequency to probability. In a way, frequency is equivalent to probability. X is a discrete random variable between A and B. Its PMF is Px equal to k. Then the mean of x is k into probability of k and then sum over of all possible values of k. Here k is a particular value or realization of x. Mean is also called the expected value or expectation of a random variable. Now calculate the mean of square of those numbers generated by our machine. It would be same as we have done earlier, but in this case, we have to multiply the square of each number with its frequency. So if x is a discrete random number, then the expected value of x square is k square into probability of k, then sum over all possible values of k. Here k is a particular value. Following these expected values, we define the moment of a random variable. The mth moment of a discrete random variable between A and B is defined as k to the power m into probability of k and then sum over all possible values of k. Here k is a particular value or realization of x. So the arithmetic mean or average is the first moment of a random number. Here m is equal to 1. Similarly, the mth central moment is defined as k minus mean of x to the power m into the probability of k and then sum over all the possible values of k. K minus mean of x is the deviation of the random variable from its mean. That itself is a random variable. So we are calculating the mth moment of that deviation. The second central moment of a random variable is called the variance. Here m is equal to 2. We now use the definition of moment to calculate the mean or the expected value of a random variable x that follows binomial distribution. For expected value, we have to multiply k, a particular value of x, with its probability and then we have to sum the product with all the possible values of k. Here k will be from 0 to n. For probability of k, we will use the PMF of binomial distribution. When k is 0, the product of k with its probability is 0. So we get rid of k equal to 0 and do the sum from k equal to 1 to n. Now expand n choose k. Cancel k in the denominator and numerator. P to the power k can be written as p into p to the power k minus 1. P and n are independent of k, so take those out of the summation. Now replace k minus 1 by a and n minus 1 by b. Note that the range of summation has also changed. This summation is the CDA for binomial distribution, so it must be equal to 1. Now we are left with only n into p. So the mean or expected value of binomial distribution is n into p. N is the number of trial and p is the probability of success in a trial. We can derive the mean and variance of many other discrete distributions using the definition of first and second moment. The variance of binomial distribution is n into p into 1 minus p. There are several very useful theorems for expected value and variance. We will check few of those. For a random variable x, the expectation of a into x plus b, where a and b are constants, is equal to a into expectation of x plus b. And the variance is equal to a square into variance of x. When x and y are two independent random variables, expectation of x into y is equal to expectation of x into expectation of y. And the variance is expectation of x square into expectation of y square minus the square of expectation of x into the square of expectation of y. For any two random variables, x and y, the covariance is defined as expectation of x into y minus expectation of x into expectation of y. Here is another important theorem. Expectation of a into x plus b into y, where x and y are random variables and a and b are constants, is equal to a into expectation of x plus b into expectation of y. And the variance is a square into variance of x plus b square into variance of y plus 2 into ab into covariance of x and y. Similarly, you can calculate the expectation and variance of a into x minus b into y, where x and y are random variables and a and b are constants. Try it yourself. In this video, we have learned the definition of the mth moment of a discrete random variable. Using this definition, we can calculate different moments of different discrete probability distributions. The first moment is the mean of a distribution. The second central moment is the variance. The mean of binomial distribution is n into p, where n is the number of trials and p is the probability of success in a trial. And the variance is n into p into 1 minus p. That's all for this video. Thank you for learning with me.